In October 2019, more than 10,000 people were displaced when Lake Albert on the border with DR Congo burst its banks. The rising waters submerged homes, health centers and schools in Kanara Town Council, Ruangara and Kanara Sub-County. The most affected were government-aided primary schools of Umoja, Ruangara, Kamuga and Kachwakumu. With just days remaining until schools reopen on Monday next week, the district authorities say they are stuck. Where will they teach the pupils from?
When it comes to schools opening, I can say we are preparing. But we are greatly challenged. You know, we have three primary schools in Kanara Sub-County, on Lake Albert in Ntoroko district, which were completely submerged by floods. Umoja Primary School, Ruangara and Kachwankumu. Now, we are wondering, enrollment of over 1,000, where shall we put those ones? I am happy the Ministry of Education is promising to give us funds for reconstruction.
Paul Ninsima, the Ruangara Primary School head teacher, says the school had 724 pupils who are now scattered in the different camps in the district after their homes were also submerged by the waters.
The school had 724, but all these are staying in different camps because of the water that came here. We shall open on Monday, but we are not yet sure whether this will happen, because it's just recently that we received the money from the government.
At Umoja Primary School, the iron sheets of the submerged classrooms were stolen. According to the school's head teacher, Atujune Benson, they are planning on reopening just like other schools in the country, but will do this by building temporary structures in some of the camps where their children are staying.
Last year, I came and found out that more than 200 iron sheets had been stolen. I reported to police and some were arrested. We are also planning to reopen, but we shall set up temporary structures in camps where these children are so that they can learn from there.
But Benson says this will come with a number of challenges, which among them include pupils' failure to locate where the school is. Before the lockdown, Umoja Primary School had a total enrollment of 492 learners, and when the government reopened classes for upper classes in October, only 9 turned up. The candidates at Umoja Primary School sat primary leaving examinations at Nyakasenyi Primary School in Butungama Sub-County.
Challenges are many, which include that these pupils are in different camps and may try to trace where the school is and they fail. Also, many pupils, especially girls, were impregnated, which is likely to take down the enrollment from what I had previously.
At Kachwakumu Parents Primary School, there was an enrollment of 494 pupils before the lockdown. In October last year, the Ministry of Education and Sport said they were aware of the situation of the natural disaster, but said they had no funds to relocate the schools.
We convinced people to give us their land where we can set up these schools, but the requirements to use are what we don't have. We are worried that our children may not return to studying just like others in other parts of the country. As teachers, we used to stay in permanent houses, but now calling teachers to stay in temporary structures will be hard. But I call upon teachers to follow their calling and come and work. God will pay us.
The situation has left many parents frustrated. Goreti Kanyunyuzi Aboli, who had 2 children at Umoja Primary School, laments about her hopelessness. As a parent, I am confused. I have 2 children who are still young. One is in primary 2 and another is in primary 3. Looking at their school, which was submerged, I wonder where I will take them, since other schools are very far away and my children are too young to walk long distances.
The lady, Honorable Mama Janet, the Minister of Education, has promised to send us tents so that we can conduct classes from there. Because 1 month you can not complete infrastructure in 1 month, given the procedures of procurement, what. So Mama Janet has promised the First Lady tents.
However, Godfrey Kakande from Kabarole Resource and Research Center and a board member at Uganda Red Cross Kabarole branch says disasters are here to stay and that districts should put in place mechanisms to handle the outcomes.
Opinion, these disasters we have always lived with them. They are here and they are yet to come. I think I would call upon all of us to start planning. We need to work together, we need to be coordinated in our efforts such that we pull our simple resources to manage these disasters. For example, I know Uganda Red Cross has a warehouse established in Fort Portal, and that warehouse has non-food items.
Report by John Antusi Ngwiri for the news in Fort Portal.